Hi folks, and welcome to a relatively short announcement. Well, what can I say? This is me we're talking about here. But for those who enjoy listening to my voice, I can proudly announce that thanks to the editing and effects work of BrianJ1962 and the tenacity of my publisher to actually get an audiobook up and running on their book website, the audio version of Checkmate is finally available. Link in the hoo-ha bar. As to whether it will be available on anything like Audible or that sort of thing, I've got no clue. Basically, I'm a very low-selling author, and I consider myself very lucky that my publisher has actually put the audiobook on their website in the first place, because it's involved quite a considerable amount of work on their part. Yeah. And that's not to mention the work put in by Brian J. And, yeah, put it this way, I thought the 2 days it took to record it was bad enough. Yike. Yeah. There is a sample there, which is the first chapter in its entirety, I think. Just over 20 minutes. Yeah, the first chapter is a difficult one in the book because it has quite a scene to set, and it's as the book goes on that the comedy starts to grip. But yeah, it's, if you're interested, or you think you're going to be interested, it's probably worth hunting down the reviews on the printed book, what few that exist, to form an opinion on it first. Like I said, there's not very many reviews because I'm not exactly a high quantity selling author. To put it mildly. I've had it at 5 hours, 5 minutes and 56 seconds, and I was thinking of shaving 1 second off to make it the magic 5:55. But my publisher sort of has it at 5 hours, 5 minutes and 51 seconds. So yeah, where they managed to lose 5 seconds, I haven't got a clue, but there you go. I think it's slightly got them a little befuddled because they've put the keyword selection as robots science fiction. Yeah, what a keyword selection. But there you go. 18 parts to download, and it's a total of 109.2 meg. That's what we've brought it down to, and I had to compress it a bit higher than I thought that I would have liked, because the publisher said, you know, got to make it easy for people to download. So if you do decide to go for this and you have an opinion on the download size as opposed to the quality compression, let me know. If I get a reasonable number of copies sold and it's worth investing the money in it, then I'll do Genie as an audiobook next year sometime. None of these books have actually, either physical or audio, has actually covered the outlay that I've put out. But, you know, that's not totally what it's all about. But, I can't totally spend all my money on these things, if you know what I mean. The vanity does have a certain limit. But anyway, it's up, it's out, it's, it's up there. I consider myself very lucky that the publisher actually put it up on their websites to start with. Whether they'll actually go to the extra trouble of having it on Audible or any other audio service, I don't know. This has got to be financially viable and worth the effort for the publisher, as well as me. And I am such a low-selling author that I'm just very lucky that that they're publishing my books at all, to put it mildly. But what do you say? Books went the way of YouTube, YouTube vanity a long time ago. In fact, books got there first. You just got to write the books, not with the view of getting famous, because I think you've pretty much got to sell your soul in order to achieve fame these days. And the minute you do that, I think your ethics are out the window. So books got there long before YouTube ever did, which I think is what primed me for seeing the whole thing as it was going to play out on YouTube, because it had already played out in books. And the author information, by the way, reads: Michelle's first book was in 1996, and she's been writing ever since, and getting better, or so she promises. And I've just spotted a mistake there, and I'm going to have to get in touch with them pretty damn sharpish. Yes. Ouch. Hopefully, by the time this video makes it up, that error will be corrected. Oh hell, it had better be corrected. Right. But anyway, it's up if you're interested. There it is. And time will tell. Like I think I've said on other services, it's up to me to actually produce a book that people want to talk about. That's the point at which I think I will achieve some measure of success. Pushing bad works, it doesn't, nobody gains anything, and it only ruins reputation. If it's up to people to actually like things and want to talk about them themselves, that's how things go forward. And up until that point, I've just got to keep practicing and keep churning out the books. Yeah. Like the videos, I just gotta keep churning things out until I reach a point where I'm talking about things that people want to talk about. And I'm going to stop this before we get up to the 10-minute mark, because that would be absolutely stupid. Yeah, even by my measure of standards, that would really take the mick for a quick announcement. So I'll catch you folks later. Bye for now.